Good morning. Welcome to MNC Group Investor Forum 2022 for group meeting of PT Daya Mitra Telekomunikasi TBK or Mitratel. My name is Andrew from MNC Sekuritas who will moderate this meeting. So the theme strengthening Indonesia's resiliency and transformation in line with effectiveness of various strategic efforts by the government in boosting economic recovery during the pandemic. In addition, the G20 presidency is the right momentum for Indonesia to contribute to the global economic recovery through the implementation of various strategies, transformation, integration, and synergy in all lines. Now, the four-day conference will be attended by domestic investors as well as a network of investors abroad who have partnered with AGCO in more than 125 countries. This event consisted of 3 days of corporate forum with the leaders of Indonesian listed companies and closed with the highlight of the event, namely the macro days, that welcomed all participants to attend keynote addresses and dialogues from Indonesia's policymakers and capital market regulators. Now, to start the session, please allow me to give a warm welcome to Mr. Hendra Purnama, the Chief Investment Officer of PT Daya Mitra Telekomunikasi TBK, who will present the business updates of Entel. So without further ado, the management will start by presenting the latest updates on Mitratel, and we will follow that up with a Q&A session. If any of you have any question, participants can just type it on the chat box, and I will read it to Mr. Hendra Purnama. Or you can also use the raise hand feature, then I will lead the Q&A session. Now, I'd like to invite Mr. Hendra Purnama to give the company update of Mitratel. Mr. Hendra Purnama, the time is yours.
Okay, thank you. Maybe we can start with the video presentation. Okay, we start with the video presentation. Thank you and good morning, investor and analysts. Thank you for joining the conference, the presentation for Mitratel. Think after you see the number in the video presentation, I will continue with a couple more page of our presentation. Then after that, we can enter into a Q&A session. Okay, next slide. Okay. So this is the management of Mitratel, the short name of the Mitratel Komunikasi. Our CEO is Pak Theodorus Ardi Hartoko, and our CFO is Pak Ian Sigit Kurniawan, which also head of our risk management. Our COO is Pak Pratikno Arif Buniman, and our commercial officer or our business director is Bu Nur Hayati Chandra Suci, and myself, Hendra Purnama, as the CIO. Most of the management have experience between 20 to 25 years in the telecom sector, or myself in the capital market, as before I was an investment banker. Okay, next slide. Okay, Mitratel is not only the largest, but we also the widest tower operator in Indonesia. More than 58% of our tower is actually located outside Java Island. That gives us the benefit because now more and more MNO or mobile operator is actually planning to expand outside Java. So we are actually in the right space. In terms of the data consumption in Indonesia has been grown quite significant since 2016. This is also continue with the data traffic, continue to upward trend related to the use of the VCon, YouTube, and other video streaming. This is a new opportunity for us as a tower operator, not only to become like a property company, but more toward a digital infrastructure. Right? We are also operating in Indonesia, which is now actually at the highest ROI. We have a long-term contract. We have the one of the highest EBITDA margin compared to other country. And in terms of barrier to entry, Indonesia one of the most difficult one. Not only as an entry barrier, but then to grow within Indonesia, there's also a challenge. Okay, especially for the foreigner. Okay, next slide. So in 2021, this is just a highlight that we did finish our IPO with the use of proceeds of 18.8 trillion rupiah or around 1.3 billion US dollar. We also finished to acquire 9,000 tower in 2021. We signed MOU for fiber optic, not only with Telkom, but also with the Alita, as one of the fiber optic company in Indonesia. We also received an award related to our recognition from the government. This is the award from the president for us in terms of the ESG and also our contribution to develop and to cover Indonesia. In short, for the tenancy ratio, if you see that our tenancy ratio before 2017 is mainly flat, is it because that most of the mobile operator is focused on the Java market? But then start in 2018, all of the MNO start to look at the outside Java Island. Then our tenancy ratio is quite significant. And if you see our revenue between 2019 to 2020 is also almost double, is because the non revenue or contract, a new contract from non-Telkomsel. Okay. Our tenancy ratio in 2021 is dropped to 1.51. That's as a result of the 9,000 acquisition that we did in 2021. If we take out the acquisition, then our tenancy ratio at 1.71. Okay, next slide. Okay. So this is our future or our target 2023 with the new development of 5G. We are aiming to become a digital infrastructure company. And to become a digital infrastructure company, we do have an ecosystem that we already developed. One is the tower leasing, which is the tower itself. Now about 80% of our tower is a big tower, which more than 50 meter. What we call it a macro tower. Then we also going to develop a micro tower, which is less than 30 meter and also pool, usually about 7 to 6 meter. This is to cater a 5G signal in the future. Second is the project solution. So in this case that in the future, MNO or mobile operator just give us the equipment or give us the instruction, and we can install the device or doing some adjustment and maintenance for the device. Three is a power to tower. At the current time, more than 1,000 tower is located off-grid. So we need to provide the electricity for that site. We have about 615 that using solar panel. Okay, so in the future, we are collaborating with the other with the third party to actually not only limit to the off-grid, but we are looking the opportunity for on-grid and then adding a solar panel to add a revenue from Tradel. Four is a managed service. Managed service is basically to we not only maintain the passive equipment such as the tower, but also active equipment. That can be active equipment belong to us or belong to the MNO. Fifth one is the edge computing. It's like a data center but located in the tower. We have been discussed with a potential client and also collaborate either with a startup or a big IT company. But this one, we're going to expand or we're going to invest accordingly when the demand is already there. Okay. And then the last one is the fiber optic, which is one of the most important part because, for example, 5G will not be able to operate without connection, fiber optic connection. And for 4G itself, when using a fiber optic, then the experience in the end user will be a lot better. Okay, next slide. Okay, this is the guideline for 2022. In terms of the revenue increase, we actually aiming 10%, and in terms of the EBITDA increase, about 13%. CapEx that we are allocate for 2022 is 9.9 trillion rupiah. This is for the inorganic and also organic. Inorganic, I start from the organic part, will be the between 3,000 to 4,000 new co-location, which means that we need to do a strengthening for the tower itself. To build 750 new tower, I think 2 weeks ago, we already announced that we actually already get mandate for 1,200, to build a 1,200 tower for the location non-3G. Okay? So it's already above our target. We also planning to build 6,000 kilometer of fiber optic. Our contract or our MOU with Alita actually to cover 5,700. So we are very close to meet our target for this year. And for the inorganic, we are planning to acquire at least 3,000 tower this year. Okay. I think this is the last slide from us. Maybe we can go to Q&A.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Hendra Purnama, for the comprehensive presentation. Now, before we are entering the Q&A session, let me repeat myself. If any of you have any question, participants can just type it on the chat box or raise hand. Before I open the floor to the participants, let me ask the first question to Mr. Hendra Purnama. The rental potential is expected to increase in line with the rapid growth of the data traffic in the country and in line with the implementation of 5G. How can MTEL compete in this regard?
Okay, thank you. I think as I mentioned, we do have the ecosystem that actually designed to cater that opportunity. Fiber optic is actually one of the key points because without fiber optic, then the high demand of the bandwidth will not be able to meet. That's why we are building the fiber optic. And this also going to be a bundle service to the mobile operator or MNO. So for the new tower, we're going to provide a contract that consists the lease of the tower and also the connection to the fiber optic. This is the connection also usually a limited connection. Then by the time 5G is already more adopted in Indonesia or many users use 5G, then the mobile operator can increase the bandwidth to us. The contract itself is the same with the other contract. It's going to be 10 plus 10 years in terms of the tenor.
Okay, thank you for the answer, Mr. Hendra Purnama. Now we have another question from the participants. The first question comes from Mr. Nyoman. He asks, what action are going to be done with Mitratel towers that are still adopting the 3G or 2G network? Will it be upgraded to the 5G or 4G,
sir? Okay, thank you for the question. So the tower, most of the tower, especially in the rural area, we also use 2G, 3G, and 4G equipment in the same tower. So if 5G is coming, most likely the one that will be rolled out by the mobile operator is the 3G. Okay, so in the tower itself, still remain the same. We're going to use the same tower, but then they're going to put an additional equipment. Additional, that can be a new antenna and also a new base unit. That's actually an additional fee for us, additional revenue. Then that's for the rural area, but then within the city area where the tower is different, because in a city area, usually the tower, pole tower, about 7 meter or less than 10 meter tower, then that tower can be used for either for 4G or 5G, okay? And it can able to maintain, or we can equip for 2 to 3 tenant, depend on the location and the design of the tower.
Okay, thank you for the answer, Mr. Hendra. Now, we also have another question. It comes from Ms. Endah Purwa. So he asks, is it possible to disclose your guidance and target number so we can better see the estimation result in the 2022, maybe from the top line, bottom line target, or EBITDA margin?
Okay, maybe I need more color on what's actually the question, because I already disclosed our target, yeah, for 2022 in terms of the revenue growth is 10%, EBITDA growth 13%, and for the tower itself, the tenant, the target is about 3,000 to 4,000 this year. Okay, and we're planning to build at least 750 new tower, and we're also planning to build 6,000 kilometer of fiber optic. For the acquisition, our target is 3,000 tower minimum at least for this year.
Okay, thank you for the answer, Mr. Hendra. Now we have the third question come from Nita. So she asks, if could you please get into some preliminary expectations for the need of CAPEX in 2022, just based on some of the new business you see coming on?
Okay, so yes, that's why we allocate 9.9 trillion. Those money is basically come from the IPO. The IPO itself was 18.8 trillion rupiah. So the 9.9 is actually from the use of proceeds for IPO, and it's allocated for organic and also inorganic.
Okay, thank you for the answer, Mr. Hendra. Now, we have really a lot of questions coming from the participants. Now, there's the fourth question is coming from Ms. Halfa. So she's asking, what are MTEL's strategies in facing the fierce competition of the power business?
Okay. Especially for us as a big tower with the other two, three big players in Indonesia, we are not competing in terms of price war. We actually providing the best quality service and a new product to the MNO. So every MNO or mobile network operator have a report award that give it to their vendor. So in 2021 and 2022, we are very focused in providing a quality report. Hence, as a result, we receive many awards, either as one of the best tower provider for them. For example, in Telkomsel itself, in 2021, they give us award as the only vendor that has the perfect score in terms of the quality and service. We also receive award from the other MNO such as Indosat and XL. So the quality is definitely the one way to go. So for example, if there's a malfunction in the equipment, we can respond within the next couple hours. If there's a disconnect electricity from PLN, then our backup power can last at least between 1 to 2 hours, depending on the SLA. And on top of that, we provide a new product. One is the connection, two is power to tower, And then at the later stage, the manage to manage the active and passive equipment. And when the 5G is already commonly used, we're going also to provide edge computing. So many new product that we are already have in the pipeline, we are preparing at the current time, actually give us a new edge in computing with the other tower operator.
Okay, thank you for the answer, Mr. Hendra. Now we have another question. I think I can take like one last question before the end of the session. So the last question came from Ms. Enda. So she asked, what's the impact of the merger between Tri and Indosat to Mitratel?
Okay. The consolidation in the MNO level has happened in the past, and we believe is still maybe after the Indosat and us, there's going to be another consolidation happen in the future. That's possible, and we already have a plan for that. But the positive side of every consolidation, the new entity usually more aggressive, they have stronger balance sheet and higher capex. So we actually look very keen and look forward because the new entity itself, the Indosat and Hutch, they already discussed to us that they have quite a massive plan to grow and to build a new coverage. Even from the Kominfo, the government already informed them that they need to add another 11,300 sites. So there's also a potential business for us, okay? Because as I mentioned, we are the widest, so we basically cover about 85% of all landmass in Indonesia. So this is give us the priority to them. If they want to cover a new area, then most likely we already have the tower that location. So we very keen, but on top of that, we also need to wait on when the internal consolidation of Indosat and Hutch is going to finalize. The announcement is already there, but then internally they're still doing the internal consolidation. Hopefully within the next couple months, when the consolidation is done, they can give a big order of a new co-location to us, or maybe also several to the other tower operator.
Okay, thank you for the complete answer, Mr. Hendra Purnama. Now, since the time is almost up, last but not least, Mr. Hendra Purnama, can you give us like some closing remarks to conclude today's session?
Okay, thank you. I guess Mitratel, if you compare to the other tower or to the industry, we are actually growth almost double, or I can say double compared to the tower industry in Indonesia. Tower industry growth around 5%. Our 2021 growth is 11%, and our 2022 growth is also double digit, which is 10%, which is double from the industry growth. So not only that we are secure for long term because our contract with our client is 10 year plus 10 year, so give us a continued revenue, recurring revenue every month, but also we have a significant growth in the industry. So we are not only planning to be the largest in Indonesia, but also one of the largest tower operator in Southeast Asia within the next 1 or 2 years. So we would like to put Mitratel in the global map as one of the, not only the biggest, but then the best tower operator in Indonesia. And maybe I also can add in terms of the dividend, with the best, with the result that we have, which is quite good in 2021, then we are proposing to actually give the maximum dividend, as we already mentioned during the IPO, which is 70%. That one will be approved in the AGM that is targeted sometime next month. Okay, I think that's all from us.
Okay, thank you for the comprehensive presentation, Mr. Hendra. Now, to all participants, that concludes our call for the session. Now, for your information, we will still open the registration of Macro Day, MNC Group Investor Forum 2022, that will present notably policymakers from Ministries of Republic of Indonesia, Indonesian Financial Services Authority, and Indonesia Stock Exchange. Now, so don't miss this event. I would also personally thank all of you for attending the call today and the management of PT Daya Mitra Telekomunikasi TBK or Mitratel. Now, for your information, there's an upcoming group meeting at 11 a.m. today will be PT MNC Capital Indonesia TBK or BCAP. Now, thank you, Mr. Hendra Purnama, one last time, and the management team of Mitratel. Thank you also to Ibu Susi Meliana for attending this event. Now, I will end this meeting for today. See you next time. Thank you.